यू, एम आई ऑडिबल मैम?
यू
ओके, सो एज आई सेड, कैंडी इज अ टूल विच विल बी स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम राइट फ्रॉम द क्वांटिटी टेक ऑफ, राइट फ्रॉम योर ड्रॉइंग्स इट विल बी स्टार्टिंग एंड यू कैन यूज द टूल टिल द एग्जीक्यूशन ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट. Till completion of the project, this tool can be used properly to manage your project.
Okay, so this is dedicated towards estimation, planning, and execution of the project, civil projects.
Yes, ideally, a project manager who is handling the project is having a lot of use of this software because he can understand the entire project in one software itself. Okay, he doesn't have to use different entities like. For estimation, you may use Excel at the moment. Many of the clients, they use Excel sheets.
Yeah.
And for planning, they use some other software like Primavera or MS Projects.
Yeah.
Okay. So for each and everything, you are using some other software. Okay. Basically,
yes.
You are using different entities.
Yeah.
So this Candy is a tool which brings all these features into one software.
Yes. Okay.
And this software has been existence here around for the past 40 years. Past 40 years, people are doing the research behind Candy and they have developed this software.
Okay.
So let's say we start today the session here from a QTO module. Okay.
Sure.
Let me just show the bill of quantities. This is a small bill of quantities over here. Okay. And there is already some rate analysis done here. Okay.
So bill of quantities
right
is
now,
the list of works that are needed for this crusher building work.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes. So these are the main items which is going to be happening in this crusher building to complete the project.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay.
So right now, what we do is we need to bring some quantities here. Okay. And we will bring these quantities from the drawing module. Okay. So first I will go here in the bill preps. There is an option here called QTO manager. Okay. So I will create a new package here. Okay. Let's say I will create a new package here with a code 02. And let's say this is my sample takeoff. Okay. So you can always create n number of packages here. Okay, once you have done this, just double click this. Okay, Candy will take you to a byproduct of Candy, which is called QTO, quantity takeoff.
Okay.
This is an additional product which is being developed by CCS itself.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this product is actually taking part of the drawings and taking off the quantities from drawing.
Hmm. Okay. So students, if you can relate to it, the quantity takeoff part, that is the measurement and quantity calculation part that we were doing, we see the drawings and do that on paper. The same thing can be done in this plugin.
Okay. So this is how ideally the QTO module looks like. Okay. You have a measurement bin
so
here.
So we are unable to see your screen actually.
Oh, yes. I think now you are able to see it.
Yes.
Okay. So this is the QTO module. And when you first click this measurement bill over here, you will see the BOQ, which is there exactly in the Candy.
Yeah.
Okay. And there is a drawing list available here. Okay. You select this drawing list and do a right click and say attach. Okay. So you can browse into your system and create a drawing list. Okay. Let's say I will open a small drawing here. Okay. So this is actually a PDF drawing. Okay. So Candy, this QTO can support all these files. Okay. It supports from your AutoCAD. It supports PDF. Then if you have 3D models in Navisworks format, it can support that. Then all type of images can be opened in the Candy software.
Okay.
So once, let's say now I'm opening a PDF drawing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You just open at the first time, it will ask you the measurement systems. Okay. How you are doing the measurement. Let's say I'm doing everything in meters, in the metric system, and say, okay.
Okay.
So the first time whenever you do measurement in Candy, so Candy does not know what is the scale which you have considered while drawing this drawing.
Yeah.
Okay. So first and foremost, that we need to calibrate the Candy, that what is the calibration of the drawing. Okay.
Yes,
for that,
like
you
setting
at least,
up the scale.
Yes.
Okay.
So you need at least one measurement inside the drawing, which will give you the idea about what is the scale of the drawing. That means from this point to this point, the distance is it is showing around 18.99 units, but you can tell Candy that this is 4.32 meter. Okay, and just select the proper units and say end. Okay, so now your drawing has been calibrated. So now whatever you do take off from this drawing, it will be coming in the perspective way.
Okay.
So let's say I'm first coming here. There is a folder option here, measurement folders. Let's say this is batch 2, or maybe I can say this is my excavation part.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say for all the excavation part, I will be taking off the quantities in this particular section. Okay. There is a area tool available here. Okay, you just click this area tool. Let's say this is my clear site. Okay, you can give a shading color to whatever you are actually taking off. Okay, and you have four types of quantities available here. One is a build quantity, one is actual, one is claimed, and one is finite.
Yeah.
Okay, so in the point of tendering, always you will be using the build quantities. While executing, you will be having actual quantities and claim quantities.
Yeah, yeah.
And only when your entire project is completed, you will be understanding the final quantity.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say we will be using the build quantities now. Okay.
Yeah.
And this is a clear site. What I will do is I will take the outer dimensions.
Yeah.
Okay. And from here, I'm just tracing the entire drawing now.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the portion I'm going to clear for the project. Okay. So you can just do the clear site like this.
So are you able to navigate through the drawing just like AutoCAD?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
This will be having the snaps just like AutoCAD.
Okay.
Okay. So you can navigate. Or if you have an AutoCAD drawing also, it will be looking in the same way.
Okay.
Okay. So just like AutoCAD, you are able to snap this drawing, and you need to trace what is the part you are going to cover now.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's say I have completed the drawing.
Yeah.
Now you can see the entire section is being shaded from the yellow color.
Yes.
Okay. Just do a right click here and say open takeoff sheet. Okay. Yeah. Now you got area here. Okay. That is, this is around 6212 meters square. Okay. So with this area, I also get a perimeter of the project.
Yeah.
Okay. So the area tool will give you these two components, area as well as perimeter.
Okay.
Okay. So with these two components, what you can do is you can create n number of takeoffs. Okay.
Yeah.
Or you can use these two items of this, say, shaded region.
Yeah.
And you can get different quantities from that. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's say the first quantity, what I'm going to do is the clear site. Okay.
Yeah.
So there is an option here which will directly link this quantity to your BOQ. Let's say clear site. And here, all you know that the total area I'm going to clear it. So I'm just dragging and dropping here. Okay. From this area, I just dragged and dropped here. I got the result here.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So after this, you can mention this. This is my clear site total area. Okay. In the comments, you can mention whatever you like, or you can also mention your name that you have done this takeoff.
Yeah.
Okay. Once this is done, okay. Let's say the second item, what I'm going to do is in my BOQ, it is excavation part.
Yes.
Let's say that the excavation part is also done in the same area. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's say I am doing the excavation for 2 meters. So I'm creating a variable here.
Yeah.
Okay. This 2 meter is known to me. So I can create this variable. Okay, and here I can say excavation depth.
Depth, yeah.
Is 2 meter. Okay, so this will vary from project to project. Okay, so what I will do is I will drag my area back into this excavation and foundation and drag the variable D which I created now as depth and do a multiplication over here.
Yeah.
Okay, so it will directly give me the total volume of excavation.
So in this formula bar you are able to write the formula for that particular item, right?
Yes, ma'am. You can write the formula here also. Even here also, you can write the formula. So this formula column is kept to do the calculation part.
Yeah.
Okay. Just like how you do the calculation in Excel, like one column or one cell multiplied by another cell. In the same way, here we just multiply by the name of each and every component. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This is done. Okay, you can see that this is done. You just have to close this. Okay. Let's say I have completed my excavation part, and for the backfilling, I will use the inner beams over here for my backfilling. Okay. So what I will do is I will create a new area tool. But this time, what happens is since I have already drawn this. Okay. So it is actually having a shaded all over the drawing, yellow color. So what I will do is I will right click on this folder excavation and I will create a subfolder here. Okay.
Yeah.
And I will select the subfolder. Now this is gone. The excavation shaded part is gone. So that now the drawing is again a fresh piece to me. Okay. And this time I will select this and say this is my backfilling.
Okay.
Okay. And we will be having a color like this and say start. And this time, let's say I'm only taking the inner to inner dimension. So as I will be doing the backfilling only.
Yeah.
So
backfilling, okay, you're just selecting the area wherever you will be doing the backfilling.
Yes, ma'am. The inner part only. I'll reel the balconies and the sections which is hanging outside. Yes, outer part. Okay, so this is only the area which I'm going to backfill. Okay.
Yeah.
So let's say my depth was 2 meter and my backfill was around 200, or let's say this is 250 mm. Okay, I'll create a variable here as depth 2 meter. Okay, let's say this is the depth 2 meter. Okay. And I will create another variable here called as backfill.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's say this is also in meter, and let's say this is depth. Okay. I'll just drag the D here. D minus 0.25 meter.
Okay.
So here I'm just writing a note here, assuming backfill depth as 250 mm. Okay, so that means I'm going to fill my 250 mm, that is I'm going to put some materials of 250 mm, and then I will do my backfill in the remaining part. Okay,
so that means I have in the next part.
Yes, okay. I have to cover around 1.75 of the depth of this area to do the backfilling.
Yeah. Okay.
So I will just bring the filling part over here.
Yeah.
Bring the area and multiplied by the that depth. Is backfill depth. Okay, this will give me the volume of soil required to do the backfill. For backfill. Okay, you can mention a comment like this and you can close it. Okay, so let's say I have done my excavation part all. Okay, so I will do a concrete part now. Okay, for concrete, what I will do is I will create a new folder here. Okay. Okay, let's say this is for my concrete part. Concrete works. Okay, and I will select this folder. Again, whatever the shaded I did was gone now. Now this is again a fresh start for me. Okay. Let's say this time I'm going to calculate all the beams, all the columns which is there in the plan. okay. So you can always have a column plan also. Okay, yeah. In this, if you can see, these are actually my columns over here.
Yes.
Which is a square column. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's say there is a counter tool over here. Okay, let's say these are my foundation columns.
Hmm.
Okay, and let's say I have a shade of, let's say, oh, start. So I'm just selecting wherever my column positions have been marked.
Okay.
So if you have a column plan also or a foundation plan, that will be more helpful because it will be only having the foundation parts.
Yeah. I hope students are able to appreciate how convenient kind of tool it is when the drawings are large. So what we are doing here is that depending on the type of measurement for each kind of work, we can conveniently use the tools to do the measurements in the quantity takeoff tool. Okay.
Okay. And since you can see that there is a snap option also available.
Yeah.
So it will not allow me if I don't have a particular snap. So yeah, I want to select this column, but it is not allowing me. So you can come here and remove the snap option.
Then you can go to the middle of the column. Yeah. Yes.
So you need to be very accurate about while doing the takeoff. Again, this is only a tool. How you use it is again up to you.
Yeah.
If you want to do a very good precision, you need to zoom everything and properly do it.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say these are the locations where my columns will be placed.
Yeah.
Okay. And I'll just right click and open the takeoff sheet. Okay, now you see I have total 19 numbers of columns in this plan. Okay, I will create a variable here. Okay, let's say this is my C size. Okay, and let's say the size of my column is 400 by 400. Okay, this is in mm, so I am writing the formula in meter because everything is in meter for my drawing.
Yeah.
So this is a size, so the same meter square. Okay. And here you can mention like assume column size as 400 by 400 mm.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So now you just come here and you select the columns in the foundation. Okay. The foundation concrete columns.
Yeah.
Okay. You also need the height. Okay, let's assume the total height of the building is 10 meters. Okay, so here you can mention that height of building is 10 meters. Okay, so you have the number of columns. Okay, you have size of one column and you have height of the total building. Okay. When you multiply all these three factors, you will get the concrete volume required to complete these columns.
Yeah.
So number multiplied by the C size. So this is the volume, the surface area for all the 19 columns.
Yes.
Okay. Multiplied by my height. So this will give me the total concrete quantity which I need to pour into the all these columns to complete it. Okay. Yeah. I'll just close this. Okay. So now you can see that this part is taken care of.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's say I'm going to start my beams now. Okay.
Yeah.
To do the beams, there is a length tool available here.
Hmm.
Okay. So let's say these are my beams. Okay. And we start it. Okay. For beams, what we do is we capture the running meter length.
Yeah.
Okay, so how the beams are actually running inside the project, you just need to trace that part off.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say these are the beams. You can see I missed out a point. You can always press escape and go back. Okay.
Yeah.
So maybe I will switch on my snap. So this will be giving me more precision.
Yeah.
So I'm just tracing out wherever the beams are coming in my plan.
Yeah.
I just need the running meter length.
Yes.
Again, if you have a proper beam plan, which is only showing you all the beams.
Yeah.
As you can see, this plan is having all the room size and all.
Mm-hmm.
OK. Okay, so let's say my beam is not completed yet. There is some other beams running parallelly here.
Yeah.
So you can say continue from here and you can join these lines also.
Okay.
Okay, in the same way, just say continue here and from this particular section, I have a beam here. So say okay and again continue. Okay. So I'm just tracing wherever the beams could possibly be in the plan.
Yes.
Okay. And let's say I have another beam here itself. From this point, it is starting from here to here. Okay, I need to select this point. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just selecting my beams. Okay, done. So this is the place where my beams are going to fall.
Yeah.
Okay. So once I'm done with that, I just do a right click. Okay. So this time what I'm the known part here is the size of the beam.
Yeah.
Okay. You will get the size of the beam from your schedule. So
yeah.
You can create a variable here as B size. Okay. Unit as meter square. And let's say the size of the beam is 0.350 by 400.
Yeah.
Okay. You can mention the size here. Size of beam is 350 cross 400 mm. Okay.
Yeah.
So you have the running length, you have the size, you will get the quantity now.
Yes.
Okay. So come here and select the beam item in the BOQ. Bring the length. Okay. And bring the size. Okay. And multiply them. You will get the total beam concrete volume.
Yeah.
You can mention here concrete for beams. Okay.
Yeah.
So this. Okay. Then just close it and you can see your beam part is also taken care of.
Yes.
Now let's say I'm doing my slab part.
Okay.
For slab, I will again use my area tool.
Yeah.
So let's say this is my slabs here. Let's say start. So if you want, you can also have a fresh start in a new sheet. Okay. Let's say I'll just
as in new sheet here. Of works. Okay.
I will create a new subfolder here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I will rename this as slabs.
Okay.
Okay. And select this.
Mm.
Okay. And let's say here I will do my slabs part.
Yeah.
Okay. So let's say for slabs, I only take the inner to inner distance of the room.
Yes.
So I'll just select this particular section, which is required for me.
Yeah. So I hope students, you are able to appreciate because you have done all this on paper. You can appreciate how easier it could be when you are using a software like this. Although you can do all this in AutoCAD and punch in the values, but it can go wrong anytime.
No, the point is that when you use AutoCAD and Excel, it will take a manual error also. If you punch something wrong, you cannot understand, and you would never know what are the quantities you have actually taken care of.
Yeah.
Like now I have completed this section, so I can see that this has been highlighted in this purple color or red color.
Exactly.
So I understand that this quantity I have completed.
Yeah.
So I don't have to worry about that.
Yes.
But the same thing you cannot do in AutoCAD, or it will take much more time. You need to hatch or put the shade to that region.
Yeah.
So it will be time consuming for you also.
Yes.
So here what I will do is I will open this. Okay. I got the total area, I got the total perimeter now.
Yes.
So now what I can have is I can and I have certain sizes known to me. Like first thing is the thickness. Okay. Thickness of the slab.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll just comment here as thickness of slab is 150 mm. Okay, 150 mm means this is actually 0.15 meter. Okay, and let's say my floor to floor height is 3 meter here, or let's say 3.2 meter.
Yeah.
Okay, so this is my floor to floor height. Okay, let's say I have two doors. You can like quickly count here just by looking in the drawing. Okay, that you have one door here, then 2, 3, 4 doors, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4 windows, 5 windows. Yeah. Okay, let's say I know the sizes and doors, windows. Okay, I'll create a door here. Okay, let's say the size of my door is 1.75 into 2.2 is the size of my door.
Yeah.
Okay, you can mention this size of door. Okay, so now I have similarly 4 doors in my plan. Okay, you can always put a factor here as 4. Okay.
Yeah.
And then you have a size of window. Okay. Let's say the size of my window is 1.5 into 2 meter. Okay. This is the size of my window. Okay. You can mention here window size. Okay. Again, I have a window size. Now I have 5 windows. Just multiply here. So now I have my area as well as I have my perimeter.
Yeah.
Okay. With these two figures, I can capture a lot of quantities. Like, first thing is my ground slabs, okay? For ground slabs, I will use this area, okay? And multiplied by the thickness of my slab, okay? It will give me the concrete volume to be poured in the slab. Okay? And let's say the second thing what I'm going to do is I will take the internal plastering of this room.
Yeah.
Okay, so here I will bring the perimeter, okay,
okay,
multiplied by my height. Okay, this will give the total surface area inside the room. But I have some deductions here, that is I will deduct my door size.
Yeah,
so I will just subtract this. Okay, and also my window size, so I will just subtract these two quantities.
Yeah.
Okay, so you get the internal plastering after deduction.
Yeah.
So in this way, you can quickly do. Now you have created all these variables and you have linked all these items. Okay.
Yeah.
So each and every time when you go to all the other rooms, you will be having the same parameters. Okay.
Yes.
So what I will do is I will quickly copy this sheet as a template.
Okay.
Okay. And say okay to this and I will close this. Okay, now what I will do is I will go back to the next room here. Let's say start, this is, I will say this as my room 2, or maybe I can say this is my slab 2. Okay, and I will start the takeoff part. Okay, again I will start tracing the internal part. I'll just quickly on the snap here. Let's say this is the total area which we are going to complete the project. Okay.
Yeah.
So now you can see that I got the total area.
Yeah.
So if you see now my sheet is again blank. I need to fill all these details.
Yeah.
But since I have copied that as a template,
yeah,
what I can do is there is an option here called takeoff list. Okay, now you can see that you have these two things over here.
Yeah.
This come to the slab 2 and in the code option, you select the area tool which we used earlier.
Yeah.
Okay. So now if you open the takeoff sheet, everything is automatically linked and you get the quantity also.
Yeah, yeah. We directly have all the formulas that we entered earlier.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
So in this way, it will be very easy when you have a big project. So all some parameters will be same for all the projects.
Yes.
And
students, are you able to understand here, like the small deductions that you can easily miss while doing manual calculations can be taken care of when you're using softwares like this?
Okay. And suppose just for argument's sake, here your door size is changing from 1.75 to it's 1.5 into 2.1, you change here, corresponding quantities will be changing and you don't have to worry too much about the calculation. It is already been done here.
Yeah.
Okay. So in this way, QTO part will help you to quicker roughly estimate all the drawings which you have.
Yeah.
As I said, this can handle multiple drawings over here. Okay. And we are also quickly coming for the 3D takeoff also. Maybe hopefully by this month end, we will be having a successful 3D takeoff also.
So in 3D takeoff, it will be a 3D drawing that we have to...
3D model, ma'am. It's a 3D model which you will be taking out from Revit. Revit. Mm-hmm. And you will export the Revit model into Navisworks file.
Mm-hmm.
And there is an option here for Navisworks. Okay, you need these two setups from Navisworks which will help you.